Hello, Andy. How are you doing today?
Very, very well. Flew in this morning, and it's all very hectic.
Nice and early. 3 a.m. wake-up call. We love those. We're at Money 2020 in Amsterdam. It's going to be three crazy days, very busy, and hopefully very valuable. So first of all, Sphonic, which is a Fintech Power 50 member, so we're very proud of it. If some of the viewers are not familiar with your organization just as yet, very unlikely, could you please give us a helicopter view of what it is you do?
Okay, so fundamentally we're a regtech company, regulation technology servicing the fintech community. We're a technical conduit, a gateway. We enable our clients to access multiple data points from various innovative companies to build a digital picture of their customers, to enable them to accept them in line with one regulation, whilst also managing the threat of fraud and risk.
And you work so in fintech, which is going to be today the main topic of conversation. You also work in the gaming world, right? The betting, gambling,
Indeed we do. Fundamentally though, any of our clients where they accept consumers or businesses in a not present way, we can serve them. Where data is present and data needs to be brought together to create a picture to enable acceptance, we can serve customers.
So any recent announcement or something you're very proud of, you're going to release soon, any exclusive for the interview today?
Well, absolutely. This year, you know, when we launched the company 7-8 years ago now, our launch product, Workflow Manager, was fundamentally a gateway, an API gateway, API in, API out, real time. Lots of our customers were saying, how do we analyze what's taking place? So we've now built a real time stream, enabling our customers to build real-time dashboards of what's taking place. Now, that could be from a technical perspective, third-party vendor timeouts, match rates, all sorts of error codes and declines, but also to identify risks. Instead of having that crystal ball and knowing what's taking place and what predefined strategy you have to build, you can actually visualize what is taking place. Are we suddenly turning down a disproportionate amount of customers? If we are, why?
So you provide actionable insights to your clients to be able to quickly, basically, make informed decisions.
Absolutely, actionable insight. Yeah.
Good, that's what we want, actually. And the RegTech is so busy, but at the same time, a handful of players are really making a difference. So, and again, I'm glad you're part of the Fintech Power 50. We had Money 2020, so huge event, arguably one of the biggest one in Europe. It's a lot of money as well and investment in time. So. Why and how useful is it and valuable to Sphonic and NT?
It's incredibly useful to us. We actually started out at the Money 2020 in Vegas, and then we've been coming to Europe for the last 3 years. First of all, it's our real target market of high growth fintechs. It's exactly where we want to be and where our client base sits. Secondly, because we're a gateway to all these innovations of other third-party suppliers, we're here to continue our ongoing research of new interesting data feeds, new interesting technologies that we plug into our platform, enabling access to our clients.
So Money 2020 is a good source of leads, of insights, of business relationships and connections.
Leads, research, and just general brand awareness. You know, we're a B2B business, not a huge amount of consumers would ever be aware of us, but obviously we want the industry to know we're here, and know we're growing, and hear of the good things we do, whether it be through new releases or interviews such as this.
So good investment in terms of time and budget. Last but not least, I mean, I wish I could talk about Liverpool, maybe football club, because I thought you would.
What a great night on Saturday.
Sorry for the Spurs fans out there. But no, the last question is about being like a fintech leader, like and leading your organization and RegTech in particular. According to you, in a nutshell, what are the key challenges for growth, actually, in the fintech space in 2019?
Quite fascinating. You know, one of the reasons we set up our business was to adapt to changes in trends, but also to adapt to changes in regulations. You know, we've got the upcoming fifth AML directive, we've already had PSD2. One of the big challenges, all the companies we speak to seek to expand geographically. Expanding geographically means new data sources to meet regulation. And it's just this scalable efficiency. We've moved away from this world of empire building. And you know, part of our role is to sort of take away what we do from our clients. Let us do what we do. You focus your resource within your business on growing your business. So that's why everything's incredibly collaborative with us and our clients.
Well, thank you very much for your time, Andy. We wish you the best, and see you at the next big event, probably very soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.